हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एट योर होम। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट डबल सर्कुलेशन। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, एज इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट ब्लड एंड इट्स कंपोनेंट, हार्ट एंड इट्स स्ट्रक्चर, एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस लेक्चर। सो नेम एज इट सजेस्ट, डबल सर्कुलेशन मीन्स अ सर्कुलेशन इन विच ब्लड सर्कुलेट्स ट्वाइस इन अ हार्ट, ओके, ड्यूरिंग इट्स पाथ ऑफ सर्कुलेशन। सॉरी स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस जस्ट सी द डायग्राम ऑफ द हार्ट। I have made a diagram just for representation. See, this is the right atrium, this is the left atrium, right ventricle and left ventricle. Okay students, what happens? Blood comes from the body organs to the right atrium, and then it reaches to the right ventricle, and then from here it goes to the lungs by the pulmonary artery. And students, in the previous lectures I have told you all, this is the only vein which carry the only artery which carry deoxygenated blood, okay, and blood reaches to the lungs, and after getting purified this blood goes once again to the left atrium, okay, then through the bicuspid wall goes to the left ventricle, and there is large artery that is called dorsal aorta, okay, dorsal aorta, and it branches into many small arteries, and these all arteries facilitate the transportation of blood which is oxygenated to the different body organs. Okay, again coming back to the right atrium, so see, blood is coming into once in during this path, and again after the lungs it coming again to the lung heart. So during this path also blood is going during this part. Difference is, this is impure blood and this is the pure blood. So this is the double circulation, okay, and double circulation is also divided into two parts, that is systemic circulation, and next is the pulmonary circulation. So students, let's first discuss systemic circulation. Okay, systemic means blood coming from left ventricle to body organ and coming back to the right atrium. This is the path of systemic circulation. Okay students, this is not so tough topic. Okay, very simple. Means blood goes pumped by the left ventricle, goes to the body organ, and again coming back to the right atrium, okay, by the superior vena cava and inferior vena cava, okay, that path is called systemic circulation. And then next, the pulmonary circulation. Students, it is little bit confusing, which one is this? Is this path is the pulmonary, or this path is the pulmonary? So let me tell you all, pulmonary is the branch of the one of the branches of the medical science. Okay, listen to me, pulmonary is one of the branches of the medical science, like cardiology is there, one of the branches, okay, and neurology is one of the branches of the medical science. So pulmonary is the branch of medical sciences related to the lungs. Pulmonary means exactly lungs, okay, in the terms of medical science. So when blood passes through the lungs, this is called pulmonary. So in the case of pulmonary circulation, you must include the lungs, okay, and what are the things apart from this lungs to be added? That is the from where it is coming, and from after being passed through the lungs, where it is going finally, okay, one step then before to lungs, and one step after the lungs. that is the pulmonary circulation. I think you all are not going to forget it. And the next, that is the disorder of heart. Disorder of heart. Student, it's very, very important because this is very confusing. Sorry for interruption. Actually, disorder of heart is diagnosed by test. First is the troponin, second is the ECG. Many more are diagnosis is there. Okay, but these are the two main types, main way to diagnose the health of the heart. Troponin test is especially for the heart attack, especially for the heart attack. Okay, and because troponin is the name of enzyme, yes, troponin is the name of enzyme when heart going through the heart attack, it releases its enzyme, very special enzyme that is released in case of only heart attack. Okay, especially in case of heart attack, and little bit about the cardiac, and in little bit about in the case of cardiac arrest also. Okay, but especially into the heart attack, and when person have gone through the heart attack, the level of troponin is checked through the patient blood. Okay, if the level of troponin level, the level of troponin is higher, more higher than 2, 3, 4, it's very, very, very severe heart attack. Okay, person needs to be stabilized by keeping his her into the ICU. Okay, so let's discuss one by one. Heart attack, when muscle of heart does not receive proper blood due to blockage in coronary artery, okay. So see students, this is the right atrium, upper two atria, and this two lower. See, let me tell you in big diagram. Okay, see, so this blue color, this is the mainly coronary artery. This is coronary artery. It is branching into two. This is the left one. This is the left one. This is the right one. So there is no problem in many cases with the left coronary artery, but right coronary artery is broad, cover the very broad area of the heart, and coronary artery is the artery which supplies the blood to the heart. Okay, for example, the brachial artery and radial artery supply the blood to the hands. Similarly, coronary artery is the only artery which supplies the blood to the heart. Okay, this is the coronary artery branching into two, left and right. Okay, so especially there is a problem with the right coronary artery. Okay students, and next is treated by angioplasty or bypass surgery. Angioplasty means doctors, means cardiologists just insert a stent and they remove the clotting of the blood. Okay, if it is impossible to do the angioplasty, just do the bypass surgery. What is the bypass surgery? Suppose this is a coronary artery, there is a blood clotting, so they just cut from here and here, and just did they arrange any blood vessel of the same diameter from the other part of the same person's body, and they just make like this. So blood is not going through this way, but blood is going through this way. So that is done in bypass surgery. Okay, both surgeries are very costly and very very time taking. Okay students, next is the cardiac arrest. When SC node does not work properly, leads to stop the heartbeat. When SC node, see in this previous diagram, see, I told you there is a, this, there is a, see this साइनोएट्रियल नोड या एससी नोड, दिस इज कॉल्ड पेस मेकर, मेंटेन्स द हार्ट बीट 72-75 बीट्स पर मिनट. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो व्हेन इट स्टॉप्स वर्किंग प्रॉपरली देन दिस सिचुएशन इज कॉल्ड कार्डियक अरेस्ट. हार्ट अटैक मीन्स रिलेटेड विद द मसल ऑफ द हार्ट एंड कार्डियक अरेस्ट रिलेटेड टू द एससी नोड. ओके, टू द स्टॉप द हार्ट बीट पेशेंट फेस ब्रेडिकार्डिया. ब्रेडिकार्डिया लो हार्ट बीट मीन्स वेन हार्ट बीट लोअर टू 72 बीट्स पर मिनट. वेन हार्ट बीट्स गोज डाउन एक्चुअली 70 आई कैन से दैट नॉट 70 सॉरी 60. ओके, वेन हार्ट बीट्स गोज बिलो टू 60. ओके, देन इट इज कॉल्ड, दिस कंडीशन इज कॉल्ड ब्रेडिकार्डिया. ओके, एंड इन दिस कंडीशन पेशेंट शुड बी केप्ट बाई द केप्ट अंडर द विजिलेंस ऑफ द कार्डियोलॉजिस्ट एंड हैज़ टू बी गिवेन अ फैसिलिटी ऑफ द पेसमेकर. पेसमेकर फर्स्टली इट इज गिवेन टू पेशेंट एक्सटर्नली. ओके, by lying down the patient in the ICU and pacemaker is outside the his body. Okay, for stabilizing the condition of the patient. If he is being stabilized by the that pacemaker keeping outside the body, okay, then after 2-3-4 days he will be having his or her normal life. If as soon as they remove the artificial pacemaker, okay, if his heartbeat goes down once again, then there is a requirement to fit that a very smaller size of the pacemaker into his muscle, not in the heart, just above the heart, in I can say in the muscles of the rib cage, in the chest muscles. Okay students, in the chest muscle, that very small, I think this up this much size. Okay, so I think you all have got. Listen me carefully once again. Cardiac arrest can be treated by pacemaker. The body having pacemaker, that is called SA node. That is a natural pacemaker. If it is it doesn't work, then artificial pacemaker is implanted into the his chest muscle, not into his heart. Okay, just go through Google, you will be seeing the artificial pacemaker. Next, the heart failure. When ventricle does not sorry, one more thing. Cardiac arrest, see, there is a to diagnose the cardiac arrest, one more method is there, that is the ECG, electrocardiogram, that is called ECG. okay, the person is not just feeling that he is stable, okay, he has chest pain, okay, then he should go for the ECG. okay, electrodes are attached to his body or her body. Okay, and I can stimulus is given outside from the outside source, external source. Okay, to let his heart work properly. So coming back again to the next topic, that is the heart failure. When ventricle does not pump enough amount of blood, that is 70 ml. Okay, when 70 ml is not pumped by each ventricle, then this is called heart failure. Means body organs not going to have the sufficient amount of blood. If sufficient blood is not supplied to the body organs like brain, kidney, then they are not going to perform properly. Okay, and this in this condition they may fail to perform. Okay, a person leads to the death. So this condition of heart is called heart failure, means heart is getting failed. Okay, heart valves are not functioning properly, especially the reason behind this reason. The reason behind for this कंडीशन इज कॉल्ड हार्ट वॉल्स आर नॉट फंक्शनिंग प्रॉपरली, सम अदर रीजन मे बी देयर. ओके, द मेन प्रॉब्लम इज द विद द हार्ट वॉल्स. एंड वन मोर थिंग, सी व्हाई आई एम सेइंग 70 ml, एक्चुअली वंस ब्लड इज कमिंग हियर इन एवरी बीट्स 120 ml, 120 ml, एंड 70 ml आर जस्ट गिवेन आउट बाई दिस एंड दिस ऑल्सो, 70 ml फ्रॉम दिस, 70 ml फ्रॉम दिस, एंड 50 ml रिमेन्स देयर इन टू द वेंट्रिकल. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ नेक्स्ट इज द एंजिना पेक्टोरिस. इन शॉर्ट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एंजिना ओनली. ओके, लो और नो सप्लाई ऑफ ऑक्सीजन टू हार्ट मसल. वेन हार्ट मसल मीन्स कार्डिक मसल डजेंट रिसीव द प्रॉपर अमाउंट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन, देन लीड्स टू एक्यूट चेस्ट पेन. ओके, इफ एक्यूट मीन्स थोड़े समय का, बहुत ज्यादा. ओके, देन दिस इज कॉल्ड एक्यूट पेन. ओके, अपोजिट ऑफ एक्यूट इज कॉल्ड क्रॉनिक, हल्का हल्का हो लेकिन काफी समय तक हो. ओके, सो द पर्सन हैव अ अक्यूट चेस्ट पेन ड्यू टू लो सप्लाई ऑफ ऑक्सीजन टू द हार्ट मसल. एंड हाउ कैन यू रिकॉग्नाइज वेदर इट इज एंजिना और हार्ट अटैक, बिकॉज बोथ हैव द चेस्ट पेन वेरी सिवियर. यस, एंजिना पेक्टोरिस कैन परसिस्ट अप टू 7 seconds ओनली, मैक्सिमम इट कैन गो फॉर 10 seconds इन वेरी एक्सेप्शनल केसेस. ओके, बट नियर अबाउट 5 to 7 seconds अ वेरी हाई एक्यूट चेस्ट पेन. बट इन द केस ऑफ हार्ट अटैक इट मे परसिस्ट फॉर 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 5 minutes. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, एंड द लास्ट वन हाइपर टेंशन, ब्लड प्रेशर मोर देन 120 mmHg, दैट इज द सिस्टोलिक. That is the systolic means contraction of the chambers of the heart, okay, especially ventricle. Okay, and it may lead to the damages of the brain and kidney will be damaged. Okay, so doctor always suggests have a low intake of the sodium salt. Okay, that is beneficial for the heart. Okay, so student, this is all about the disorder of the hearts. I hope you all have got all the points, and in the next video we will be discussing next topic of the life process. Thanks for watching. Bye bye, take care.